فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
الحمد لله رب العالمين، والعاقبة للمتقين، ولا عدوان إلا على الظالمين، وأسلي وأسلم على من أرسله الله رحمة للعالمين، سيدنا ونبينا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين، أما بعد. وعلى وكتاب الورقات للإمام الحرمين أبي معالي الجويني رحمه الله. We finished علم, and today inshallah we're going to be talking about الظني والشكي. الظني والشكي وإن مراتب الإدراك. والظن تجويز أمرين أحدهما أظهر من الآخر، والشك تجويز أمرين لا مزية لأحدهما على الآخر. ظن and shak is what the Sheikh mentions here. ظن means, as the Abi Ma'ali al-Juwayni says, he says ظن means تجويز permitting أمرين two matters, permitting two matters. أحدهما, but one of them, أظهر من الآخر, one is more clearer than the other. والشك, and شك is what? تجويز أمرين, permitting two matters, لا مزية لأحدهما على الآخر, one does not have any superiority over the other, meaning to you they both see the same. We're going to now go into the sharah of Sheikh Abdullah ibn Salih al-Fawzan. I explained the matter. Sheikh Abdullah ibn Salih al-Fawzan says, لَمَّا فَرَغَ الْمُصَنِّفُ When the Musannif, the author, spoke about knowledge. He spoke about knowledge, تَعْرِيفُ الْعِلْمِ وَبَيَانُ أَقْسَامِهِ and its types. He finished that. We spoke about ilm and what it meant. And we also spoke about the levels of knowledge and the types of knowledge there are. What did he mention? ذَكَرَ مَا يُقَابِلُهُ He started to mention what goes opposite to knowledge. He's mentioning what goes opposite to knowledge. And what is it that goes opposite to knowledge? وَهُوَ الظَّنُّ It is ظَن. ظَن goes opposite to knowledge. إِذْ لَيْسَ هُوَ مِنَ الْعِلْمِ Because ظَن is not from knowledge. ظَن is not knowledge. Why is it not? لِأَنَّ الْعِلْمَ Because knowledge is هُوَ إِدْرَاكُ الْجَازِمِ Knowledge is what? It is a perception with unwavering conviction. You have certainty of this matter which you have perceived. Whereas, ظَن is what? إِدْرَاكُ It's a perception. غَيْرَ جَازِمٍ Where it is not certain in your heart. Are you with me? So he finished talking to you about what? Knowledge. He now went into the opposite of knowledge, which is what? الظن. Pay attention now. Perception, are you guys with me? Perception of a matter. Perception of a matter. But you do not have in your heart certainty towards it. So you do perceive it, but you're not certain about it. Occurs in two ways. The first one is أَيَّتَسَاوَ الْأَمْرَانِ When the two matters become equal to you. فَلَا يَتَرَجَّ أَحَدُهُمَا عَلَى الْآخَرِ None of the two are stronger to you in any way or form or shape. عِنْدَ الْمُجَوِّزِ According to the one who's permitting it. This one and this thing, he doesn't know the ruling for him, both of them are the same. Ah. Are you guys with me? وَإِن كَانَ أَحَدُهُمَا أَرْجَحْ عِنْدَ غَيْرِهِ أَوْ فِي الْوَاقِعِ Even if that thing, so for him, the ruling of this matter, none of the two views that stand, none of them are to him what? Stronger. He perceives the matter, but in his heart, there is no certainty of this matter. Both of them are the same. Even that though, other than him, they might find that one of the two is stronger. For other people, it might be one is stronger. Or even in reality, one of the two may be stronger. But to him, they're both the same. وَهَذَا هُوَ الشَّكُّ. That is called shak. The thing that you can't, both of them are 50-50 for you. Example is what? A person says to you, لا أدري, I do not know. طفت ثلاثة أشواط. I did tawaf around the Kaaba 3 times or 4 times. He doesn't know. They're both the same for him. He doesn't know which one he done. This is called shak. None of the two is stronger for him. The 3 and the 4 are equal in his eyes. He done tawaf around the Kaaba 3 times or 4 times. He doesn't know. But in reality, is it one of the two? In reality, it's one of the two. Or a person who's with him knows which one he did. But to him, is 3 or 4 the same? That's the first type of what? Perception with doubt. Perception that is not with certainty. Perception that's the first type. The second type is called one of the two. أَيَّتَرَجَّحَ عِنْدَ. One of the two things, one of it becomes stronger for you. عِنْدَهُ أَحَدُ الْأَمْرَيْنِ عَلَى الْآخَرِ. One of the two matters is stronger for you. Are you guys with me? Such as the person who says, we just mentioned now, طُفْتُ أَيْدَنْ طَوَافْ ثَلَاثَةَ أَشْوَاطْ أَوْ أَرْبَعَةَ أَشْوَاطْ. He says, and I think it's the third one. 3 times. Because when I went done the first time I read Surah Al-Baqarah, the first page of Surah Al-Baqarah, the second one I read the second page of Baqarah, and the third one I done some adhkar. So yeah. So he has 60 or 70% in his heart that it's what? That it's 3. So one is stronger now, sah? This is called one. Are you guys with me? The weaker one, which is 4, is called wahm. The weaker one is called wahm. That is also in his head. So he says, maybe 4 like it. But I did this. So how could it not be 3? So in his heart, which one is stronger and which one is he more leaning towards? He's more leaning towards the which one? The 3 tawaf. But then there's always that thought that keeps kicking in all the time. That keeps saying to him, nah, maybe not. That push, that kicking in is called wahm. It's the weaker view that's saying to him, it's 4. It's weak. Pay attention. So that person would say, the first one was saying, طُفْتُ ثَلَاثْ أَشْوَاطٍ أَوْ, he says, مثلا, أَوْ أَرْبَعَ. The O here is the same, it's equal. But the second time he would say, طُفْتُ أَرْبَعَةَ أَشْوَاطٍ. طُفْتُ ثَلَاثْ أَشْوَاطٍ, I done 3. ويحتمل أن يكون أربعة. So it brings احتمال. And it's possible it could be 4. 4 is a possibility, you see. Whereas the 3 is more of a strength in his heart. والظن درجات. So pay attention, brothers. Are you with me? Knowledge is perception with certainty. Doesn't that mention? Perceiving something as it is with certainty. That's what we said. Anything that is perception, but not with certainty, is what? In 2 ways. The two matters become equal to you. 50-50. This is called what? Shak. It's called shak. The second type is called that one of the two becomes stronger for you. One is stronger. The one that's stronger, it's called dhan. The one that's weaker, it's called wahm. Pay attention. We need to understand the istilahat al-muhaddithin and istilahat al-fuqaha are different. Wahm, we're studying usul al-fiqh. Don't go to the, when we were talking about kathratul al-awham, when we were talking about the al-ta'an in the hadith, which is the criticism that comes towards the narrator. Al-ta'an fi al-rawi. Nah, don't get it wrong there. So the Sheikh goes on to say, Sheikh Abdullah bin Salih al-Fawzan, he says, وَظَنُّ darajat. The dhan, but it's of levels. So what was the dhan? The one which is stronger to you. From the two views that you have the stronger side is called what? It's called dhan. And the dhan is of levels. The highest of that is called غَلَبَةُ dhan. It's when it's 99.9 or even 99. Are you guys with me? غَلَبَةُ dhan is called. And it will come to us in more details. وَالشَّكُّ as for shak is what? ضِدُّ الْيَقِينِ It is the opposite. Shak is what? Shak is what? Shak is ضِدُّ الْيَقِينِ It is the opposite of what? Certainty. جَاءَ فِي لِسَانِ الْعَرَبِ It has come in the book, Lisan al-Arab, is written by Ibn Manzur. He has a book called Lisan al-Arab. He said, Al-Yaqeen is al-Ilm. Yaqeen is knowledge. Wa izahatu shak. And it's the removal of shak. It is the removal of shak. Wa tahqiqu al-Amr. And it is the reality of the matter. Having the comprehension of the reality of the matter. So what did he say? He said, وَالْيَقِينُ ضِدُّ الشَّكِ Yaqeen is the opposite to shak. وَهُوَ فِي الْأَصْلِ وَهُوَ فِي الْأَصْلِ In the original Arabic language, the word yaqeen, pay attention, means what? بِمَعْنَ الْإِسْتِقْرَارِ When something becomes still. Are you with me? When something becomes still. يُقَالُ It is said, يَقَانَ الْمَاءُ فِي الْحَوْضِ The water is still inside the pond or the valley. إِذَا اسْتَقَرَّ وَدَامْ Jameel. So the word, all we wanted from that is really is what? That the shak is the opposite to it. It's called what? Yaqeen. And what is yaqeen? Ilm. We just took it. According to Ibn Manzur. Good. وَالشَّكُّ So we understood that what is yaqeen originally in the Arabic language? Istiqrar, when something is istiqarra. Are you with me? What does shak mean fi asli al-lugha? In the language, what does it mean? The word shak in the Arabic language, in the linguistic meaning, is al-tisal wal-luzuq. It's when something is attached to something and it's around it. It's called itisal. And you all know the hadith of the Juhaniya, the woman who committed the zina. The messenger who he ordered her to be stoned, right? فَأَمَرَ النَّبِي صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَمَ The Prophet, what did he order? He ordered فَأَمَرَ بِهَا النَّبِي صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَمَ فَشُكَّتْ عَلَيْهَا ثِيَابَهَا He ordered شُكَّتْ ما معنى شُكَّتْ Her clothing was taken because when she gets stoned, her aura might show. فَشُكَّتْ معنى لُزُوم That the clothing is wrapped, لُزُوق And that the clothing is stuck to her body that her aura doesn't show. ثُمَّ أَمَرَ بِهَا فَرُجِمَتْ Then she was stoned to death. So what does it mean, فَشُكَّتْ A shuddat alayha, her clothing was taken from the sides and it was tightened on her, making sure that hawra was show or jumi'at. So pay attention. Thumma sara hadha al-lafz. This lafz, this wording, that's what it meant in the language. But then later, it got introduced and it started to be used as what? Yutlaqu, it got to be used as what? Taraddudu fi shay'aini, when taraddud means what? Regurgitation. Between two things. بحيث لا يميل القلب إلى أحدهما. When the heart cannot choose between the two, you keep saying, You don't know which one to choose from the two. You with me? Abdullah ibn Salih al-Fawzan then says, وقول المصنف, the speech of the author, he's referring to Imam al-Haramain, where he said, وظن تجويز, that the ظن means تجويز, permitting. Permitting what? أمرين two matters. Not having ability to say that this one is stronger than the other. He says, that speech of who? Al-Imam al-Haramain, he says, فيه مسامحة. There's a slight leniency in it. It's slightly too lean. فَإِنَّ الظَّنَّ Because ظَن لَيْسَ هُوَ تَجْوِيزًا The person is not permitting anything because nothing is clear to him. So for him to say that he permits both would actually mean he has a view on this matter. But when a person is on shak, when the person is on ظَن, There's not tajweez al-amrayni. There is nothing clear to him. وَإِنَّمَا هُوَ الطَّرَفُ الرَّاجِحُ Rather, astaghfirullah. The word dhan, the reason why it's not tajweez is because he has both of them are not permitted to him. One is permitted to him. Shak is why he said. Dhan is the strongest side, correct? Isn't it not? So the reason he said, وَالظَّنُّ تَجْوِيزُ Imam al-Haramain said, Dhan is tajweez. Fihi musamaha. He said there's a leniency, very lean, very soft in that usage. That's not correct. Fa inna dhanna, because dhan, laysa wa tajweezan. Dhan is not permitting something. وإنما هو rather than is what هو الطرف الراجح is the angle that is stronger المقابل للطرف المرجوح that is the opposite to the one that isn't clear as I just mentioned the tawaf the three and the four which one is than three because the person feels stronger towards the three he's more inclined to the three over the four the weak one is called what and the opposite one is what which is the four it's called wahm and which is wahm واما غلب so that's the dhan واما غلبه الظن what does غلبه الظن mean غلبه الظن means when a person has a high level of dhan well dhan is a bit higher now فهو قوه الظن is when your dhan reaches a bit stronger here it could be the dhan can be up to what from 60 to what 99.9 it can be dhan because 100% is what is ilm or yaqeen فإن الظن فإن الظن يتزايد. Sometimes a person might say three or four. It's three. Yeah, it's most likely three. You know what? Definitely. It's three. He starts saying all of that, and then then he gets stronger, and he says, you know what? Until it becomes sometimes what? Sometimes it becomes certainty. ويكون بعض الظن أقوى من بعض. Sometimes a person's ظن might be stronger than another person's dhan. Good. قال أبو هلال العسكري. أبو هلال العسكري, he says in his kitab al-furuq fi al-lugha, differences in the language. غلبة الظن. غلبة الظن is what? عبارة عن طمأنينة الظن. غلبة الظن is when your dhan it becomes tranquil, slightly you start settle down on it. وهي رجحان أحد الجانبين, and it's when the two sides one is becoming stronger for you. الآخر رجحانا مطلقا a strength is entering which is general يطرح معه الجانب الآخر which then necessitates that the other side might be tossed severely it's getting you get it's erasing the other side that you're saying three no three because I didn't read anything else and the person's mind as he thinks on it gets stronger and stronger and stronger you see وَظَنُّ pay attention this is according to Ahl Sunnah وَظَنُّ وغلبة الظن ظن and also غلبة الظن ظن is just when it's 60 وغلبة الظن when it goes up and it goes higher كل منهما both of them يقوم مقام اليقين they stand the position of certainty in terms of what? Ruling the way you would take a ruling which comes to you by way of certainty is the same way you're going to take a ruling if it comes to you by ظن doesn't matter we don't care about that عند الفقهاء according to the فقهاء وأهل السنة ويجوز and it's also permissible بناء الأحكام to base a ruling الشرعية عليه you're allowed to base a ruling on ظن you're allowed to إذا فقد اليقين if the person doesn't have certainty in this matter he can base a ruling on what? ظن الذي قلما rather it's really little يحصل عند الاجتهاد rather it's little that a person by way of اجتهاد to come with certainty it's really little Ijtihad is really based upon what? Dhan. So based on what? Mainly. Rarely can a person base a ijtihad on certainty. Does that make sense? He bases it on what? Dhan or ghalabatul dhan. You see? And because of that, ولهذا and because of that, يجب العمل بخبر واحد. You have to implement a singular narration. Remember when one person tells you, he heard from one person, is there a chance that the person can get it wrong? Even though he's a reliable person, could he have not got it wrong? Can the person that told him not got it wrong? And then the person who told him, could they have not got it wrong? Is the chances very little? But is that, and so what happens is, dhan is present, that this person could have done a mistake. But you still base a ruling on it. إذا كان ثقة, as long as the person is a reliable person. ويجب العمل, and it's also obligatory to implement what? بشهادة الشهادتين. Shahidaini, sorry. And you also have to base a ruling on two witnesses. Two witnesses come to you and they say to you, Fulan stole. The judge, does he base a ruling on it? I base a ruling on it. Could they have both agreed upon lying? They could have. Could they have both taken some finance from somebody or somewhere and they wanted to do this? Could they have done it? Yes, they could. It's done. But a ruling is going to be based on it. You see? وخبر المقومين and also the news of a land measurer A person who measures people's lands and says, your land, this is how much it is, and land for this person is this much. Can he get it wrong by the way he measures people's lands? Can he give you something that's not yours, take some of your rights away from you and get it wrong? Or also, the muqawwimain sometimes can be that you send a person, you send a man who's good at the lands, and you say to him, go and look at my land and check it and tell me the value of it. And then he looks at it, he tells you the value. Could it be less than the real value that it's worth? Could it be? He's a muqawwim. The ruling is still good. The judge, Islamic qadi, will base a ruling on that muqawwim speech. If he's a specialist, would he base a ruling on it? He would base a ruling on it. He will base a... But the two muqawwimaini, the two of them, if they're reliable, akin. Also, وَيَجِبُ اسْتِصْحَابُ حُكْمِ الْحَالِ. Also, istishab. Istishab is dhan, which is what? Basing the matter on the original essence. It could have been possible that the matter wasn't this case. Istishab is what? Istishabul hal, bringing the person back to the original essence of what they were. Such as a person who doubts whether they broke their tahara. Are you with me? What is he going to do? Istishab, go back to the original what he was. What was the original that he was sure of? He was sure that he had the purity. So he goes back to the original essence of what he was at the beginning. Not the beginning of his creation, but I mean the beginning of the essence of what he was before he doubted it. What was it? He was sure about, he had a tahara. That's the istishabul hal. That is the situation he's aware of, which is that he had tahara. He now suspects whether he broke it. Is there a possibility he could have broken the tahara? Yes, they could have. But we don't care. We're going to base the ruling of the dhan here that's present, which is what? So it's dhan that we're basing it on by bringing him back to the original essence. You see, Ibn Farhud al-Maliki said, the great scholar, the Maliki scholar, Ibn Farhud al-Maliki, in the book Tabsiratul Hukam, or the Kitab Fathul Ali al-Malik, he said, وَيَنْزِلُ مَنْزِلَةِ التَّحْقِيقِ. It stands in the place of ruling-wise, acceptance. الظَّنُّ الْغَالِبِ. ظَنُّ الْغَالِبِ, which is high assumption. It's taken on board. لِأَنَّ الْإِنسَانَ, because if a person, لَوْ وَجَدَ وَثِيقَ, if a person finds a letter, فِي تَرَكَةِ مَوْرِثِهِ, his father left behind, a letter that your father wrote. Or وَجَدَ ذَلِكَ بِخَطِّهِ, or he finds that in his own handwriting. Like your father, he has a letter written, in which he states a ruling on this issue. Are you with me? And you find it, and you know your father's handwriting. Are you with me? Can you base a ruling on it to say, my father, he left a letter behind, which he states that he owns this land. Can you go to Qadi and say, my father owns this house? It's my father's land. Here's the letter he wrote. Here is the contract of the letter that my father signed with the people of the land, the house. Can a ruling be based on it? Or does the father have to be present? La. Hukum and a ruling will be based on it. And you can say, Wallahi, in the judge. Ibn Farhun al-Maliki is going to tell you that. Or وَجَدَ ذَلِكَ بِخَطِّهِ, or he finds it in his handwriting. Or بِخَطِّ مَنْ يَثِقُ بِهِ, or in a writing of a person he can rely on. أو أخبره عدل بحق له, or a person who's reliable informs you that your father used to own this, and this was your father's land, and that he was there that day. مثلا, فالمنقول, that transmission of that speech to you, it is permissible for you, جواز الدعوة بمثل هذا, you are allowed to go to a court and claim your dad's rights. والحلف, and you can even say, والله بمجرده, just by that letter, you can say والله in the court, or the news of that person. وهذه الأسباب لا تفيد إلا الظن. And all of these matters, what do they benefit us? So all of them is ظن. دون التحقيق. They are not حقيقة in a reality. But, لكن, ruling will be based on it. لكن غالب الأحكام والشهادات, the majority of rulings and also witnesses, إنما تبنى على الظن, is based upon ظن. وتتنزل منزلة التحقيق. But he takes the ruling as though it is like certainty. انتهى كلامه, his speech is finished. وفي الفقه مسائل عديدة. In fiqh, there are a lot of matters. This is the speech of Abdullah ibn Salih al-Fawzan. وفي الفقه مسائل. In fiqh, there are a lot of matters. عديدة, a lot. حكم فيها بالصحة. In which the Sharia judged for it acceptance. Based on what? بناء على ما في ظن المكلف. All of it based upon what? The dhan that is present upon the individual. It based a permissibility based upon the individual's dhan. As for that which has been transmitted from the evidences from the Kitab and the Sunnah that prohibits implementing dhan. You see some verses in the Quran, مثلاً, that prohibits a person basing a what? A action or a ruling upon dhan. فَهُوَ ظَنُّ الْمَرْجُوحِ. This dhan that's been spoken about is the weaker of the two perceptions. The two perceptions. The three tawaf and the four tawaf. The one that was three was what? The three was dhan. And the four we said it was what? Wahmun. The waham is what the Sharia is referring to here. That the person is the dhan which is marjuh. The dhan which is weak. الَّذِي لَا يَقُمُ عَلَيْهِ دَلِيلُ. Which evidences don't stand with it. You have no evidences for it. Rather, it stands with what? بَلْ هُوَ قَائِمٌ عَلَى الْهَوَى. But rather, it stands on what? On whims and desires. وَالْغَرَضُ الْمُخَالِفُ لِلشَّرْعِ. And the intent for it is to oppose the Sharia. قَالَ تَعَالَى. Allah says about those people, إِن يَتَّبِعُونَ إِلَّا الظَّنِ. They do not follow except ظَن. وَإِنَّ الظَّنَّ. But the ظَن لَا يُغْنِي مِنَ الْحَقِّ شَيْئًا. It does not what? It does not suffice you from the truth. So that means that the ظَن here, it opposes a haq which is present. Like in this person who has the letter that his father left and it wrote, do you have anything to oppose him with it? No. There's no opposition on him. Pay attention. وَقَالَ تَعَالَى. Allah says, إِن يَتَّبِعُونَ إِلَّا الظَّنَّ وَمَا تَهْوَى الْأَنْفُسُ وَلَقَدْ جَاءَهُمْ مِنْ رَبِّهِمُ الْهُدَى. إِن يَتَّبِعُونَ, they do not follow except ظَن. وَمَا تَهْوَى الْأَنْفُسُ, and that which their souls are, they want. وَلَقَدْ جَاءَهُمْ, and it has come to them. مِنْ رَبِّهِمْ, from their Lord's guidance. والله أعلم, وصلى الله وسلم على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين.